Hey guys, how you doing? JP Sauricolia here, and welcome to another episode of Age of Heroes, my podcast. This is episode number 177. It is amazing that we are getting this far, and in no time we'll be in 200, that's for sure. And I'm excited for it. It definitely has been, the last 2 years have been amazing. I've been doing, of course, as many of you know, I've been doing this gig for as a full-time, which has been crazy, scary. Some days I just want to throw the towel. I want to give up. And there are days that I just say, you know, I need to give it another chance. I need to put the extra mile today, and I continue on. I move on. I'm probably so hard-headed. I think that's what it is. But I'm grateful for God's opportunities, you know, that he has given me through all these platforms that I have. You know, I partake here in YouTube with my different channels, but also through this podcast. And, you know, on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, I try to share everything, you know, I do and all of that. Of course, it's not always the best. It's not always, I always get the results I want. But ultimately, it's about experimentation. And I think the most important thing is the fact that we are able to share hope and to share life with people in one way or the other. I believe that life and hope is something that we all want. We want joy in this world we live in. I think we've been going through difficult times. You know, since I think always, but I think since last year with the pandemic and this year as well, it's been a reminder that, you know, there are the little things that we sometimes take for granted are the most important things in our lives, that they require the most of our attention. Now, in today's podcast, I really want to talk about something that really caught my attention this week. And of course, I think I'm exuberant. I'm happy for it. The fact that the PlayStation, well, in this case, Sony and the PlayStation decided to save the PS3 and the PS Vita for the time being, and they're not going to close the stores. It is a victory for gamers, and definitely it's good. I'm excited for it because, you know, I was really dreading the fact that it was closing because there's still a lot of games that there in those systems that I need to purchase. And ultimately, you know, it's a lot of games to purchase. And I do have an extensive catalog of games, digital games on those systems. And I still play my PS3. Lately, since it was announced that it was closed, and I've been going back and I've been purchasing games. But I've been playing a lot of games that I never finish. I just wanted to play them. And also getting some DLC that I never got the chance to get. So it's been like a planning thing. And I was like, man, I only have 3 months to get all this done. And of course, money is always tight. And particularly now that I'm always working through this, it's not like I make a lot of money, you know, barely make any money. So it's been hard. So I was thinking, how am I going to do it? I don't know. But, you know, the fact that they stepped in and said, we're going to just keep it for the time being, it's good. So that gives me more time to continue on. But I've been just enjoying that. I haven't even touched my PlayStation 4 or any other system. Right now, I'm just playing PS3 because I'm in love with the games. I always love the PS3. So it's good, but definitely it's a victory. And I think this week has been full of victories in different aspects of life. Of course, in one end, we have the case of George Floyd and the guilty verdict of Derek Chauvin. That was an important part, an important page in American history. And really showcased that when people unite, when people come together and they express the satisfaction for something, there's always a good result. Some time ago, a couple of weeks ago, I talked about the cancel culture that we're facing right now, which I'm against it. I'm against that idea that you have to cancel everything, that you have to come together to try to, you know, take somebody's job or just take somebody from a project. I feel that that's wrong. However, I think when we come together as people, whatever community we are part of, and we're looking for solutions to problems or for a better, so, you know, a better result in life or in anything we do, I think, you know, there's real change and the opportunity for change happens. And that's always good. I feel that in this case, a lot of gamers got together as soon as the announcement was done. People were expressing the satisfaction for it on social media, on YouTube, on Facebook, on Twitter, everywhere. They were saying, you know, they were unhappy about it because ultimately the PlayStation, of course, the PS5 doesn't have a door to backwards compatibility yet. You know, we don't have backwards compatible games. Of course, they're trying to sell a lot of games. You have PlayStation Now, but you don't have the whole or the full list of the full catalog of games. So definitely a lot of people were unsatisfied, and there's a lot of legacy games there, games that have really built the PlayStation, that as soon as if the PlayStation store was closing, it would they would completely disappear, and there will be no access to them. And of course, the rise of the physical media for those games that are still available out there in the wild, particularly PlayStation 1 games and some PlayStation 2 games, they were going up in prices like crazy, skyrocketing. So I think that this is a victory for gamers, for PlayStation owners of PlayStation 3 players and gamers, and for gaming as a whole, because it's a reminder that when we come together, things can happen. Good things can happen. So it is not permanent. We know the PlayStation Store on those devices is not going to be there forever. But for the time being, it gets more time while PlayStation, while Sony is preparing a better way to address backwards compatibility and ways to access for gamers to access some of those catalogs, old catalogs on the PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3, through the PlayStation 5 or the PlayStation 6. So I feel that this is something that it gives them time also to prepare for what is to come, because people really care about these games and they really care about preserving the history of gaming. Now, for those who are unaware of the decision by PlayStation, I'm here at the PlayStation blog because the announcement was done here this week. It says PlayStation Store on PS3 and PS Vita will continue operations. I will have the link in the description for those who are interested. But it says right here, players will be able to continue to purchase games on PS3 and PS Vita. Recently, we notified players that PlayStation Store for PS3 and PS Vita was planned to end this summer. Upon further reflection, however, it's clear that we made the wrong decision here. So today I'm happy to say that we will be keeping the PlayStation Store operational for PS3 and PS Vita devices. PSP commerce functionality will retire on July the 2nd, 2021 as planned. Now, let's keep in mind that the PSP was already closed. It's not like you could purchase anything, but officially it's closing on July the 2nd. When we initially came to the decision to end purchasing support for PS3 and PS Vita, it was born out of a number of factors, including commerce support challenges for older devices and the ability for us to focus more of our resources on newer devices where a majority of our gamers are playing on. We see now that many of you are incredibly passionate about being able to continue purchasing classic games on PS3 and PS Vita for the foreseeable future. So I'm glad we were able to find a solution to continue operations. I'm glad that we can keep this piece of our history alive for gamers to enjoy while we continue to create cutting-edge new game worlds for PS4, PS5, and the next generation of VR. All right, and now I want to show you a tweet from Jim Ryan, the president of PlayStation. He's also was credited as the person that wrote that article that we saw at the PlayStation blog. It says right here, okay, I heard you loud and clear. We will not shut down the PSN store access for PlayStation 3 and PS Vita this summer. You can continue to buy all of those classics. And there's a link to the blog. And in the end, it says, at least while this newly increased sales numbers persist, and there is an emoji face right there. So this is an important moment for gamers. And this is something not only for PlayStation owners, but also for Xbox, for a Nintendo Switch, for PC owners, for gamers as a whole, because it really sets the precedent for things to come in the future. I think it sends the right message and companies are paying attention. And I feel that in the end, it's a victory for consumers, not only for gamers, because I believe that when we unite together, when we come together as a community and we express our dissatisfaction with something, then I think the companies are always listening. They listen because it matters to them. That's the bottom line for them. You know, if you're not spending money with them, if you're really take your money away and go to the competition, then definitely the companies are not able to subsist. And they have to do whatever it takes in order for them to keep you happy, you know, to keep consumers happy. Like, you know, the old saying always says, you know, you speak with your wallet. That's the way you do it. If you are not spending money with these companies, then definitely they have to make changes, whether it's removing someone from a position of control or whether making changes and adjustments to their system or their protocol, so that way, you know, they can reach this wallet, you know, reach your money. You know, this is good. You know, I'm excited for it. You know, I'm happy for it. And the reason why I wanted to talk about it today, not only because it compels or it's only important to gamers, is also the fact that I do believe that there is power in unity. We see that all the time. I feel that sometimes we think that companies are not paying attention. And that not only applies to gaming, it also applies to comics, it applies to collectibles, it applies to any type of entertainment, anything in the world. It applies to politics. it applies to the social interactions in this country or in any part of the world. I feel that there's real change when people come together, when they put their differences aside and they say, you know what, we need to come together and we need to talk about this because it matters. It is important to us and we want good service. And I believe that when people really do that, there's a lot of things that change and happen that are really good. Now, I would say that to anybody that is listening to this. I would say that, for example, in the collectibles world, sometimes we complain a lot, collectors, you know, statue collectors, action figure collectors, the companies are not listening. They're not really providing the product we want, that the prices are too high, are really crazy, the product are not as good as it used to be, or we complain about certain things and aspects that we think are not good for a particular piece or a particular action figure or statue. Companies listen. They listen with the numbers of pre-orders. If you are pre-ordering that, I feel that if you want to send the right message, do not spend money on things that you don't like. That's the first thing I would say to anybody. Just because you want something, but you're not fully satisfied with it, doesn't mean that you have to put money down on it because, you know, you think, oh, you know, it's going to be my last chance. No, because companies are going to continue producing the same products for the same characters, for the same licenses, you know, over time. And now we have so much competition out there in the collectibles world. With statues, there's so many companies now producing so many amazing stuff. So you don't feel like, oh, you know what? I need to buy this Batman because it's the only Batman we're ever going to get. Unfortunately, that's not true. I'm telling you, I've seen so many Batmans over the years. They're still going to continue producing Batman. And even those obscure characters, they might not get, you know, as many releases, but they do get releases over time, get improved as well. So it's about you speaking with your wallet. You know, don't just simply buy something just because you think you're going to miss out. It's the fear of missing out that I think, you know, really it stops people from enjoying any hobby. And the same rule applies to gaming. It applies to comics. It applies to any source of entertainment. It is important that we understand that it's important to unify ourselves, not simply to go blindly and to spend money with something. I feel that this is good news for the PlayStation 3. And I feel that as long as people keep buying PlayStation 3 games or keep going into this, to the PS Vita, and they go into the PlayStation Store, I think the PlayStation is listening about the importance of preserving the legacy of those games. And they're going to find mechanisms and ways to bring backwards compatibility into the forefront for the newer systems because people care about those things. You know, even though they have said in the past, like Ryan said many times, you know, he didn't care because then he's a numbers guy. He said, well, the numbers don't match up. People don't care about those things. Well, people care. Just because I don't play my PlayStation 3 as much as I do my PlayStation 4 doesn't mean that I'm not concerned about preserving my games and my previous collection because from time to time, I go back into my older systems just to play. And I want to know, I want to have the assurance that what I'm buying is going to be there, or at least for a long time, at least on my lifetime, I want to be able to know that I can always go back to this old consoles and still play my games and have no problem with that, that I can just simply plug in my system, even when there's no more connection to the network, or even when there's no connection to, you know, to the website or anything, I still am able to play those old games. And that's something that people want. They want the assurance of something. And I feel that in this, I think the whole message that the community sent to PlayStation has really worked. So this really show us that if we come together, then there's a lot of change that can be made in this world, not only in gaming, but also in the collectibles world, in the comics world, in the movies, entertainment, and in political stances of the world. I think that it's important that we take a stand and we speak with our wallet and ultimately with our voting power. It is important that we make that decision. Yes, you know, change can happen always, but it happens when people stand together. They come together, they put disagreements aside, and they come together and fight for one subject. They fight for one single thing together. Even though we might not agree with everything, even though we have differences of opinion in a lot of matters, if we come with one thing in one accord and we come together for one single thing and fight for that thing, I think we are going to see better options. We're going to see better products. We're going to see, in the end, a much better world. But what is your opinion? What do you think about this? I want to say to all of you, thank you very much for your support. Definitely, I enjoyed this podcast. It allows me to speak my mind, allows me to share my thoughts, and also to be able to open the door for other creators, content creators, allow them to speak their thoughts. So I want to tell you, I thank you for all this time that you take supporting my different channels in YouTube, also in social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Thank you for that. I ask you please to share the podcast, to share my videos with other friends, you know, through social media. So all the people can come and support this channel as well, at least, you know, watching it, you know, if they're watching in YouTube or listening to the different platforms when they listen to the podcast. Thank you for all the support. Please follow me on social media. Follow me there. Share my content there as well. Also, consider supporting the podcast, also my different channels, supporting me through Patreon. You can do that on a monthly basis. It really helps out. Helps me build this channel and my platforms and the podcast and to bring better content for you. So my friends, I want to say to all of you, thank you. Thank you very much for everything you do. God bless you. Take care. And I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye.